Well, thank you everyone for coming. My name's Liz. I'm Canadian, as I'm sure you can tell. I am here with GFL Environmental, and I'm here to talk to you about the exciting opportunity that we have to bring people to Canada to work for us. So before I get into that, let me tell you about GFL. So we are headquartered in Toronto, Ontario, and we are a waste management company, but there's different areas of space that we play in. We have three major areas that we play in. One is solid waste, so that's everything from your local garbage person and door-to-door pickup. We, in that portfolio, in that solid waste portfolio, we own landfills, we own transfer stations, and we have a long-haul trucking division. That's our largest portfolio. We are the largest solid waste hauler in Canada and fourth largest in North America. Our second division is our liquid waste. So that's household hazardous waste. So you might say, what is that? Because that's what I said when I started. So that's everything from oil. So when you get your oil changed in your car, all that dirty, yucky oil that comes out of it, we take that, we collect it. We take all the toxins out of it so it can be used and recycled. So that's one example of our liquid waste portfolio, but we've got several examples in our liquid waste portfolio that I could give you. The third and final is our construction. And the way that I describe our construction division is we're basically the people that go in there and get that space ready to build. So we do demolition, so we'll demolish the area. In big cities, similar to here, big cities, space is very limited. So we will demolish the building through our demolition company. We'll take all of that waste and we'll put it into our trucks, and then they'll take it away. We excavate the land. So, because in Toronto and where this is mostly located, parking is a premium. So we want to dig in that ground so we can do underground parking. And when you go down, and that soil is usually contaminated because it's in a large populated area. So that soil is then shipped out to our soil cleaning facilities, and there's several of them that we own. Then we shore up the walls so that the wall doesn't collapse in on itself, and then someone else can come in and build the building. So we get that area ready. So that's our construction division. So I'm here on behalf of our solid waste division today to tell you about GFL and the opportunity in working for Canada. So we've been recruiting for our solid waste business nonstop. We have been growing like crazy. When I started with the organization 4 years ago, we had 1,800 employees, so that's 1,800 employees, okay? Today, we have just under 10,000 employees. So we have had substantial growth. We are a private company, and we've closed several acquisitions a year, which means we're in the upswing of massive growth. So it's a wonderful opportunity to get in to work with a Canadian company who is established, who's solid, and who's expected to grow. So that's the opportunity. We have been recruiting for drivers in our market for about a year now, aggressively. So that's one of our beautiful green trucks, an example of some of the advertising that we do. This is what a truck, if you were to come to Canada to look at this is what the truck would look like. We are offering you the opportunity to come. We're going to get you certified to drive in Canada. And if you're under the age of 35, we'll bring you over on what's called a working holiday. We'll pay for your immigration paperwork. You'll come work for us. We will give you great paying jobs starting at a minimum of $20 an hour. And they go up from there. We will offer you, we'll make sure you have a place to live. Make sure that the living accommodations are relative to your income and that you're able to support yourself. And if you're under the age of 35 as well, you have the opportunity to bring your families over with you through the working holiday program. Over the age of 35, we still want you. It's just a little bit longer process that you have to follow. So we would be doing the immigration paperwork through Canada. If you've ever gone through it, it's called an LMIA, which is a labor market impact assessment. Our immigration consultant is helping us with that, and he's on site today. So we can look at bringing people over the age of 35. It's just a different program that we would bring. So we are here today to talk to you about the solid waste opportunities in Canada, to get the immigration stuff figured out. We brought over our immigration consultant from Canada. He's doing all the paperwork right here on site, and you could be working in Canada 6 to 8 weeks from now if you were interested, okay? So you might ask yourself, well, why the heck are we here? Why are you coming to Canada to hire some people from Ireland? And that's a really good question. I'm glad you asked me that. So I'm here because there's a trucking driver shortage in Canada. It's industry-wide, and there's also a huge mechanic. So the mechanics that work on these trucks, there's also a huge mechanic shortage. And because of our growth, we haven't been able to just keep up with the demand. And so this project was started. I spoke to people who were doing this right across Canada. I've been doing it for 6 years, and I was telling our friends over here about that. And I said, where do I need to go? You've been doing this for 6 years. So they had looked at recruiting people that were living in different areas of Africa. They looked at Poland, they looked at Germany, and they looked at all these different opportunities. And they said, by far, they have had the most success with people from Ireland. So that's why we're here. So there's 6 years of learning. I was able to fast track, and now I'm here, and we're saying, okay, it's a good fit for us. There's relationships with our governments that allows us to do this. So that's why we're here, and that's why we really want to bring you on with us. So to give you an idea on how much the shortage is, as many as 48,000 drivers we are going to be short come 2024. And that was Canadian Trucking Alliance. So they are the ones that are saying to us that we cannot meet the demand. That's even if we start taking our current people who don't have truck driving license and train them, we still can't meet the demand. So that's why we're looking internationally. So if you haven't considered a career in trucking, it's a great paying job. If you do come over, we'll pay for flights to Canada. We will take care of your immigration paperwork. We will pay for your medical. And we will have medical for you and your family. And we'll help make sure that you have accommodations and that figured out as well. So why come to Canada? I'm going to show you about, as much as I love your country, and I've only been here 24 hours and I want to stay, let me show you a little bit about coming to Canada and what that looks like. So this is a video from the Government of Canada that shows you about Ontario. And Ontario is where you'd be working. Most of our opportunities, that's Toronto, that's the Greater Toronto area. And these jobs are in and around the Greater Toronto area. So this is the city that you'd be working in or in and around there. It's our hub for theater and for entertainment. It's Canadians' hub, I would say, for entertainment. It's a wonderful time to come to Canada too. The weather is lovely, it's warm. You share your love of beer. And Jameson's for that matter. I could tell you more about Canada, but really pictures are 1,000 words. Just come in, have a seat. You can see lots of trees in Canada. That's what I was told was the big difference. Lots of trees. So let me tell you a little bit about GFL Environmental too, this amazing organization that I've had the opportunity to work with. To give you a little bit of the background on it, our founder and visionary, Patrick Avicii, started our company with one transfer station on the quarters of Toronto, and he has grown that into a North American-wide operation. He is a phenomenal, phenomenal man. I believe he's under the age of 45. I'm not sure how old exactly he is, but he's under the age of 45. And he has done it through acquisition and growth. So he has been a phenomenal man to watch. He's taken our industry and revolutionized it with adding liquid and construction to our portfolio. So he's absolutely amazing. This is one of the videos our marketing department, which is not large, but they're mighty. Created for us last year, and it'll give you an idea of what it's like to work for GFL. If you cannot hear it, let me know. So this is going to take you right across Canada to see all the different trucks. That's British Columbia, and then through Western Canada.
Our drive to create, build, and explore. It's what compels humanity to to replace complacency with knowledge and obstacles with opportunity. This drive is a fundamental key to the success of GFL Environmental. Society is now more aware than ever of the corporate and social responsibilities attached to life in the 21st century. From individuals and communities to businesses and entire industries, we all play a role in the sustainability of our environment and our economy. But how do you navigate the complexities of balancing environmental stewardship and fiscal responsibility while growing a business or supporting a community? It begins by actively exploring innovations that have the power to change public attitudes and the way industries evolve. By including big picture thinking into the handling of unique circumstances. As one of North America's largest diversified environmental service providers, GFL Environmental has the network, equipment, vision, and the expertise required to resolve practically any waste management or infrastructure development challenge. With over 5,000 dedicated employees and more than 140 strategic locations, GFL is uniquely equipped and positioned to deliver robust, efficient, and forward-thinking service solutions. GFL's strength is found in its diverse specialties and the dynamic people who perform them. From solid and liquid waste management to recycling services, waste audits, emergency response capabilities, and a broad range of demolition, excavation, and shoring services, GFL has the experience and the attention to detail required to safely satisfy practically any environmental or infrastructure concern. So why diversify? Why would a company known for collecting, hauling, and recycling traditional waste streams venture into food waste processing, soil recycling, and infrastructure implementation? The answer is simple. We listen to our customers. We developed ways to harness our collection, recycling, and disposal capabilities into powerful closed-loop systems that minimize environmental impacts and financial concerns. We built a sophisticated North American service network that can safely and efficiently reduce the number of third parties required for complex environmental and industrial needs. And in the process, we strengthened our ability to sustain our own growth and secure a better future for our company, our customers, and our environment. GFL Environmental is acutely aware that actions taken today can have far-reaching impacts tomorrow. As such, we remain driven to provide North America with safe, accessible solutions backed by a dedication to environmental and safety excellence. By doing so, GFL Environmental will continue to allow our customers and the communities we serve to be not only green today, but green for life.
So that's the opportunity. I'm not
and
sure.
Waste management. Or in-
there we go. Okay. So that's exactly what we're offering. Immigration programs that we will pay for, flights to Canada. If you stay in Canada for and work for us for 2 years, and you don't wish to stay after 2 years, we'll fly you back home. Paid training, housing assistance, and a guaranteed great paying job. So to give you an idea, the average minimum wage in Canada is around $11 and $11.50 right across Canada, the average. Our jobs start at $20 an hour, so well above that. And your medical plan is available free of charge for you and your family. I can't thank you enough for coming to see me. Thank you.
Thank you.